large interval lip slurs are lip slurs that have another note with the same fingering in between the two notes that you're slurring to and from. I'm going to start out by using the example that's in All About Trumpet, going from a C on the third space down to the C below the staff. Now, if you've been playing for a little while, you know that there's another note with the open fingering, the same fingering, in between those two, and it's the G. So as you're making this large slur, oftentimes you'll hit that G in between those two notes, between the two C's. So I'll give you an example of that. I'll start on the high C, and I'll go to the low C, and I'll get that middle G in between. Okay, so there's those three notes. Now what you're after is going from the C to the C without hearing that middle G. This will help if you actually do this with the tongue. That will help get the sound in your ear. It will also help you feel the inside of your mouth so you can feel exactly what it feels like to play each of those notes and your embouchure. When you do the slur, it's really important, as with any slur, is to keep your air moving steadily through those notes. At first, it's going to take some practice to do this. At first, you'll probably hear yourself flick on that little G in the middle, and that's okay as you're practicing. Just imagine the air flowing smoothly and cleanly all the way through from the top C to the low C, and just keep practicing and you'll get it. So here's an example, doing the larger interval lip slur going down. Okay? I did that so quickly that that G is in there, but it's so fast that you can't really pick it up. Most people can't pick it up. Now, going from the low note to the high note is more difficult. It's really important that you sing these notes so that you know that you hear them. When I'm doing this, same problem, there's that G in the middle. Now I'm trying purposefully to play that G in the middle to get that to sound, just however briefly. It's kind of hard because I practiced so long getting these slurs smooth that it's difficult to actually do it wrong. But as you're learning this, you'll probably hit on that G in the middle. And one trick that you can do is to bear down with your air before you pop up to that higher note. So listen for that when I play this time. Okay, on a couple of those, you could hear there was some space, some air, some silence in there. That was because I wasn't blowing through as much as I should have been. And, so make sure you keep that air flowing. Practice this a lot. That skip was an octave. You can do some shorter intervals. Like, for example, if I go from an E to a C sharp, so E is 1 and 2. C sharp is also 1 and 2. And there's an A in the middle that's also 1 and 2. That's a sixth instead of an octave. So that sounds like this. Again, it's easier to practice going high to low than it is going low to high. So start there so you get a feel for it. And then just work it, keep that air moving, and good luck.